Hi everybody, I'm Jim.
And I'm Rich.
And we are playing Dungeon Defenders 2 in our first episode of Come At Me.
Yeah.
An odd episode. After we finished Rainbow Six and we're like, let's do this new series. We're joined by Rich's brother Rob, who is a ninja.
Yeah, he's a resident ninja. He doesn't talk.
Silent and deadly, like a fart.
I think that depends on who's farting.
Or a ninja. I mean, let's go with ninja.
Yeah.
I have never ever played this game before.
You played Dungeon Defenders 1, haven't you?
Yeah, I played Dungeon Defenders 1.
Yeah.
Dungeon Defenders 2 is free to play.
Yep, which makes it pretty awesome. You can unlock all the characters through just doing stuff through game. And yeah. The cash shop stuff, as far as I know, is only cosmetic things. Though you can also use it for unlocking champions if you really wanted to.
Alright, so let's get this game started.
Yep, to the war table. I figure we might as well start, like, campaign normal.
Sure.
Let's see if I can find, like, the very first... Gates of Dragonfall. That sounds like the first map.
Okay. I believe you. I suspect that you're about to betray me, but I believe you because I have no choice but to do so.
Okay. I set it to a private game. Now, you guys should get a pop-up telling you to stay with me or something like that. Found session. Good. Because I'm in the process of creating it. So I have noticed that with my current settings, I do get the odd bit of lag spike. That's the way it goes. So...
Oh my god, the Bullet Witch has like a little floaty...
She's got a jetpack.
She can fly.
She can fly, wow. Okay, so right now we're in warm-up mode. We all have to press G to get out of it. But I figured I'd show you the map, Jim. Because there's some interesting things beyond regular Dungeon Defenders.
Please give me some tour.
So, some different things. One, if you come up, say, the ice cart here. You press E on it. It'll fire chunks of ice out. And I think that'll freeze enemies solid.
Neat.
Over here is a fire cart, which will shoot down flames out to here.
Cool.
These chests, as far as I know, there's what... three on the map. I'm assuming that's just because there's three of us or whatever. They'll give us green mana, which will be the mana on the right at your bottoms, at the bottom there. And that'll be used for building defenses.
Yeah.
Your blue mana, which is on the left, is used for using your abilities.
Yes.
So, simple. Some different things from Dungeon Defenders 1 to 2 is there are what's known as combos in this. I don't think we have a loadout for doing combos. But things like if you freeze an enemy solid and then hit with a strong earth attack, I think you can shatter them.
Oh, okay, yeah.
If you put, like, oil on an enemy through some abilities or defenses, and then hit them with a fire, you'll ignite them. I think the Huntress has a geyser trap, which will knock people up and make them wet, so then when they get hit by lightning, they take more damage.
They take more damage.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is basically like an agent-based tower defense game.
Yeah. And the real trick is you can't just rely on your defenses. I mean, early levels you probably can, but later on you usually don't
have
enough... Yeah, you don't have enough defenses early on. So, that's about it for now, so let's get things going.
Alright.
Oh, the other thing is everybody gets their own loot. So if you see something on the ground, it's yours.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Yeah. So, just waiting for you, Jim.
Oh.
Okay, now we're in the build phase. We can run out. Activate a chest. Get some mana. I think each person can only activate one chest.
Alright.
So it does limit the mana you have to start with, so...
I have 117...
So we're going to start. I'm going to put down a blockade. And for the guy I'm playing...
Yeah, is you like the Abyss Lord or something?
Yeah. This...
I'm a dinky apprentice here.
This is my basic blockade.
That's a giant skeleton, man.
That's a skeletal orc.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So I'm
thinking towers up on the hills. Because I've got frost towers, fire towers.
The thing to watch for is enemies can shoot, range attacks can shoot up the hills to hit your towers.
Okay. Hmm. What do you suggest?
I suggest I steal any of it. No, it leaves me like 3 mana shy of putting up another tower. Normally, with your defenses, it might be better to put like a fire turret behind each of the blockades.
Sure, let's do that.
At least to start. If you look underneath your map on the right, you'll see a little tower symbol.
Yep.
That's kind of filling up the bar. That's how many defense units we have total. You don't want to face it that way. You pick the position, then you pick the aiming.
Yeah, there's two.
We only have two towers at the moment, so Rob's probably going to be spending most of his time keeping that lane on the left clear.
I can make a small blockade for it.
How much mana you got left?
154. I have lots.
Okay. I tell you to drop me some mana, but I can't remember the command for it. So don't worry about it. I would say actually just put more towers up behind the blocked ones.
And then we'll try and use defense.
Yeah, and then we'll just defend the lane over here ourselves.
Do we want freezing towers to slow down enemies, or do we want earth towers?
I'm not a big fan of earth towers myself.
Or do we just want more fire towers?
One freezing tower per lane is good just for slowing. I don't know if they do right away AoE freeze, but I think you can get them AoE freezing later. But you usually just slow them down. My skeletal orcs will attack things as well.
Alright.
So, we can just stay with the mana we've got and start if you're ready, Jim.
Yep.
Okay. Just push G to get started.
This game looks so pretty.
Are you going to fire that ice cart right away, Rob? I will fire it once more. Move in. Tune and frozen.
Oh, yeah. So I've got the ice beam and the little fiery pellets. Ooh. Oh, I don't have to constantly flick. My staff is essentially automatic.
Yeah, I think there's an option you can change it till it's not.
Yeah, but I don't want that option.
I've got enough now. I'm going to put down a defender, a block. Whoops, that's not my block. This is.
Yeah, if you want to put down a blocker, I'll throw some towers behind it.
Yep, I got one down. So I don't think... not sure if we can upgrade defense. Yeah, we can upgrade defenses, I think, right away on this one. So things to note, don't be afraid to use your abilities.
Oh yeah, I forgot. I have, like, special powers.
Yeah. Enemies do drop different types of mana. I'm actually going to drop back here a healing fountain. Counter defenses. So now we run out, collect loot. And any mana crystals that might be lying around. Coins for purchasing things in shops.
Yeah. Purchasing things in shops or unlocking heroes and...
Coins aren't used for unlocking heroes. Those are medallions of some type that you get for completing maps.
Okay.
So I'm going to actually show off a couple of my... towers here. Actually, I think I only have enough to put up one of my towers.
Ooh.
But the one I'm going to put up... where would be a good spot for it?
Hmm.
It's on 7. It's a fun tower.
That's a big area.
Yeah, these things have some pretty decent range. But what makes them interesting? You taking a look at it?
Skeletal archers.
But you notice how they're back to back?
Yeah.
They each have their own firing arc.
Hmm.
So this will cover two lanes. If I were to leave it here, but I'm going to show off the other one as well while I'm at it. And
should I upgrade
that
my towers? This one.
Your call entirely.
Okay. Let's upgrade my towers.
So I'm just
going to... that's a sell. We don't want to sell.
No, Zed is sell. Actually, can we upgrade yet? Sometimes you have to reach certain levels before we can upgrade. Sometimes you just need
certain
mana. How do
I cancel the selling?
Right click when you're not pointing at anything?
Nope.
Is my guess.
Oh. Never mind.
Or escape, yeah. Escape could do
it. There we go.
So what do you think of this little guy, Jim? Up here on the fence.
That's kind of cute.
He spits fire.
No, I mean, some towers.
I have an ability here, which is I'm going to use for showing off, which I don't think will work when there are no enemies, so I'll wait till there's enemies.
Alright, ready to go?
Yep. Yeah, see, this guy has an ability where I can use 100 of my blue mana, give a command to my defenses, and they'll do different things.
Ooh.
Like this little guy, normally he just spits fire. And we're just going to watch him spit some fire at these guys. Now, I'm going to give him a command. Now, he's a frickin' flamethrower. But that's a lot of blue mana to do it.
I just have, like, a self heal. That's my big one. Flying is held down by bullet movement. I forgot how much fun these guys are.
They really are.
Orcs Must Die and Dungeon Defenders.
Did you play Orcs Must Die?
I have Orcs Must Die, but I didn't play it very much.
Oh. What we should do
is
one of these
times. But it's all the fun of, like, base building and messing around and...
So what we need to do, since you have... Do you have Orcs Must Die 2?
I don't know.
Because Orcs Must Die 2 has co-op.
Ooh.
That one might be a fun one to do a full campaign
on. Yeah,
off.
We might... we'll put that one on the list.
Yeah.
Oh, right. I should open the chest.
Yeah. So... This one lane, we got a warning symbol on it.
Yeah, I saw that.
I don't think we have anything telling us exactly what's coming through there, but it's a warning saying that there's one guy coming through there that's going to be bigger and tougher than the others.
So it's like an ogre or something like that.
Yep.
I'm repairing all my stuff. Okay. Well, I have 150 mana. I should presumably do something with it.
Upgrading is always good.
How do I upgrade?
Looks like you push a Q when looking at a defense. And the first upgrade will cost...
I need to be hero 50. Level 4 to upgrade defenses, which means I need to gain another level.
Really?
That's huh. I don't have the option.
Yeah, okay.
Well, then I guess more towers.
Man, I don't know if we could handle more towers. Huh, I don't know if this guy can hit down bottom from up here. Yeah, I'll have to put him over here somewhere. Maybe like... Yeah, nah. More rams!
I'm gonna build, like, a couple of earth towers if we have the space for it.
I
want to see what they do.
Yeah, sure. I won't build my ram. Just let you do that then.
Okay, so here's my plan. Because earth towers are supposed to be like super long range, right?
Yep.
Well, they're not that long range.
Well, no, I'd still put them up with the rest of the defenses. And just let it shoot.
Yeah, I was just hoping
down.
That I could like snake them right at the back and have them fire out.
Once we get high in level and get some good gear and stuff that increases range, you can. But I mean, like right now, it's just we don't have gear.
Which is the warning light?
The one on the left. It's got the little flashy thing. You should be able to see.
Oh yeah, I can.
Everything from
the
distance. Yeah.
There we go. All right.
Okay.
Let's give her.
Another thing you can do is when we're going through a wave, if you see a defense getting beat up pretty hard, you can run over to it and use R to repair.
Ooh.
Okay. So it looks like we've got 151 enemies left to go, and we're on wave 3 of 3.
Oh, sweet.
Oh, if you want to see your Earth one doing anything, you should probably go...
I should probably stand back and look at it.
What you'll see is rocks will come out of the ground at the enemies.
Huh. Oh, yeah, there it is. I'm still getting used to this UI.
Yep. It gets even more fun when the game starts getting really frantic,
mm-hmm.
and you have to play catch up, or you have to like upgrade your defenses in the middle of the match.
Yeah.
That's
like the intro level, basically.
Yeah, the first few are. And which, to be fair, when you're starting out with no gear, you kind of need that intro level.
I dig this, though. We're totally going to come back to this.
Well, we seem to have time left, so we can do another map. I'm not going to worry about going over every single piece of gear on the ground. As far as I know, things get auto-polluted into your bags after. But now...
I have a problem.
Can you sell one of your defenses?
Yeah, I can get a second. Nope, that's... There we go.
Yeah. So, if we get more into this, the kind of things you want to look for, though, is specializing various heroes, because you can bring pretty much a lot of heroes into a match.
Yeah, because you can use the Hero Forge, right?
You can use the Hero Forge, but there's also what's called your Hero Deck. And during a match, all the heroes in your hero deck will gain the same amount of XP, so they'll all level.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, and what's even cooler is you can switch between those four heroes with using F1 through F4.
Oh, okay.
So you don't have to go to the forge to switch, and you can then switch in the middle of a wave.
Yeah, so if I want to like set up towers as an apprentice and then switch over to like being a knight.
Yeah. And over here now we have treasure chests. Did you pop yours?
Yeah, I popped mine.
Okay, so it's just me being a slacker.
I'm just running around looting stuff because I'm a nub.
I'm not too worried about it now. I figure I will just go and... Ooh, I got a blue... So yeah, because of what this character is and what I plan to use the character for, I'm looking for defense health on this character.
Mm-hmm.
My defenses won't do as much damage, but I'm using the character to
you wanna
block
make
lanes. Yes.
Alright.
Ooh, epic gloves. And I have a witch's lockbox.
What's that?
I don't know. I probably need to find a way to get a key.
Of course, it's locked.
Yeah, okay. So push G to end match. Yeah.
Thanks, everybody, for joining us. Especially to Rob for being our Bullet Witch Ninja.
Yes, thank you, Rob. Now go make
We're definitely
going
to come back to this. This game is super fun.
Of course, when we come back to it, I'll probably like leveled everything up to level 50 by then.
Swear to God, man. Every time.
Okay, with how fun this game is, I'm not playing it just on camera.
Maintain a separate deck.